Thank you very much, Alessandra. Good morning to everybody, and thanks for the invitation. I'm very pleased to attend to this conference with very important topics, particularly the issue of risk and emergency actions, which I mainly dealt with in the last 2 years of my working life in the ministry, is very serious because it has a deep effect on the prevention of cultural heritage. Next, please. Thank you. In theory, the risk analysis should be the basis on which planning the conservation actions. In the practice applied to the cultural heritage is a very complicated process due to the features which the cultural heritage has. We can speak about the typological differences of the monumental structures and of the variability of the dimensions, the management models and the subjects as state, municipality, a private citizen, Catholic Church. We can speak about the number of risks, natural ones and anthropic ones. We can speak about the great gap between artistic and historical knowledge in the one hand and scientific knowledge in the other hand. Particular chemical, physical knowledge necessary to analyze the risk. Next, please. Next, please. Thank you. The transition from risk theory to prevention requires an in-depth knowledge of the specific conditions of a monument that affect its vulnerability, building typologies, constructive features, quality of material, executive expertise, changes introduced by reconstruction and transformations of the architectural and distribution structure, following changes in the use that have altered the structural strength. Above all, the decay of both surfaces and structures due to lack of maintenance. Moreover, the interest of maintenance has always been directed towards the conservation and restoration more of the decorative elements than of the structural components. And this not only for buildings in the poor environmental context, but also for monuments of more historical and artistic value. This in-depth knowledge requires many investments in documentation and analysis. Public investments in this area have always been modest, and consequently, very few economic resources have been invested in prevention, so generating a large gap between the extent of the risk and appropriate operations that could have mitigated seriousness through positive actions aimed at improving the structure strength. The results deriving from this analysis process should constitute the most effective decision support for correct planning in a context of allocation of scarce resources, as by definition public resources are. But unfortunately, the correct approach was not chosen, instead of programmatic decisions that mostly responded to different logics. So we must take note that prevention is difficult. The culture of prevention is lacking. Next, thank you. Please, the next slide. It is clear to everyone that in Italy, the greatest natural risk is the seismic one. All of us know the enormous damage in terms of human lives and loss of assets, including cultural heritage, caused in Italy by earthquakes that have happened several times over the centuries, often in the same areas. Yet there are many rules introduced for the prevention of seismic risk, but which have defined the two concepts, structural adaptation and structural improvement. An almost 50-year-long debate concluded that, as regarding movable cultural heritage, the measures to be taken are those aimed at improvement and not at adaptation. The Ministry has adopted some sample provisions. I gladly remember my disposition of April 30, 2015, issued as General Secretariat, which also provided for a very simple procedure for acquiring knowledge elements and carrying out transformation actions with the purpose of prevention with reference to the extraordinary maintenance. Particular, without intervening on a global level and with economically modest interventions, critical issues can be eliminated, mostly local, able to of originating even significant collapse mechanism. Therefore, the planned elimination of modest critical issues could constitute a sustainable intervention strategy to reduce reduction of widespread risk. Yet the vast majority of citizens don't have an adequate perception of it, so much so that, unlike what happened for energy saving policies with Ecobonus, incentives for seismic strengthening interventions through tax benefits had little, very little success as Sisma Bonus. For the same reason, public programs based on risk assessment and therefore prevention are practically absent. In fact, they would require a long-term vision to evaluate the effectiveness of the investment, while in general, the programs being linked to political and government cycles have a much less broad horizon. The failure of preventive interventions involves increasing investment of resources in emergency and then for recovery of cultural heritage after disastrous events such as earthquakes. This is exactly what happened after the earthquake in central Italy in 2016, which has caused immense damage to the cultural heritage of our regions, Lazio, Marche, Abruzzo and Umbria, and involved the 10 provinces, 138 municipalities, about 8,000 square kilometers of territory. Next, please. Thank you. The geographical singularity of the seismic events has been widely analyzed and described in numerous research studies and publications. The macroseismic scenario showed a phenomena that never happened before. The succession of three different events within a short time with maximum magnitude 6.5. The line of epicenters has moved to the northeast, affecting only partially coinciding and ever wider territories. The most violent event was that of October 30, which caused the geological fractures visible on the ground surface on the Mount Vettore. The damage also to the physical structures was immense due to the progressive weakening of the resistance capacities of the same, not only monumental structures, but also widespread historical building in the small villages scattered in the Apennine Mountains. The effect has been different. Territorial structures and the landscape have been completely and deeply transformed. Some small cities have been razed to the ground as Amatrice, Accumuli, Arquata, and many other small villages which seemed bombed. Cities like Camerino apparently seem almost intact. Actually, they are completely unusable. They are dead cities. Next, please. In the earthquake series of unfavorable circumstances happened, the repetition of events that with big violence have weakened more and more structures that since the first shock had lost much of the initial strength capacity. The largely prevalent functional typology of heritage that were churches has a greater vulnerability than the others. The construction typology of historic building characterized by poor materials and techniques further vulnerable due to the numerous transformation it has undergone over the centuries. As regard to the exposure, the earthquake struck heritage of extraordinary interest from the symbolic churches of the Christian Middle Ages, such as San Benedetto and Orcia, to the hundreds of remote and tiny villages far from the main roads, but all with at least one church, a palace, a convent, a tower, an artifact of artist interest to which the identity of those populations is anchored. Next, please. As you can see, these numbers present in the ministry's databases as very remarkable. almost 7,000 historical buildings and over 70,000 movable artifacts has been hit. Next, please. All the activities started since the first minutes of the emergency are based on the awareness of operating with an integrated approach to the specific problems of cultural heritage, however, always closely linked with all the others, one, public safety, viability, anthropic safety. The ministry has played a fundamental role into the complex machine coordinated by the civil protection, showing organizational efficiency and effective implementation, despite a continuous and painful stop and go due to the recurrence of the seismic shocks, which led to the painful loss of some monuments. These results have been possible by a well-defined organizational model with specific protocols developed in peacetime by the ministry with the directive of April 23, 2015. This model provides for a national coordinating structure headed by the Secretary General, National Crisis Unit, and many regional crisis units headed by the regional secretaries of cultural heritage. Next, please. This is the chart, the flow chart, the national unit crisis and the regional crisis unit. Next, please. The regional crisis units are organized into three operating units. Unit for detecting damage to cultural heritage with the task of managing the damage detection teams, checking and archiving the survey files. Technical coordination unit for the security interventions. Temporary storage unit and emergency service laboratory on movable cultural heritage. The effectiveness of the ministry's action was strengthened with the appointment of the Secretary General as the implementing body to ensure the organization, mobilization, and deployment of the ministry's operating activities aimed at identifying, planning, and coordinating the execution of interventions for the safety of movable and immovable cultural heritage. In this way, the integration of the ministry component into the emergency structure was made stronger, and particularly made collaboration with the fire brigade easier and more efficient. Next, please. The emergency activities carried out by the ministry concerned diversified and very complex, both by their own nature and due to the surrounding details determined by the earthquake. In this way, the detection of the damage, first at the expedition level, then at an in-depth level with a detailed survey aimed at identifying the interventions for the safety. The participation in the technical support groups, the aim was to speed up the assessment and decision-making moments by the measures of the community in the presence of risks for public safety or interruptions to the road systems. To make the monument safe with urgent interventions, which due to the complexity of the damage and of the buildings often required complex structural calculations. To make the movable artifacts safe with the recovery in temporary deposits. The temporary protection of the collapsed sites to prevent winter weather from causing ever greater decay to the buried works, the rubble management. In the second phase, the recovery of movable artifacts as places become accessible and safe for operators. Okay, next, please. In the organization of the emergency, the Comando Carabinieri Tutela Patrimonio Culturale, CCTPC, has played an important role by the central office and the 8 operating units. Next, please. Next, please. The operational deployment described above all has allowed to guarantee the necessary coordination with the structure external to the administration in charge of emergency management, as has actually happened on time with the inclusion in the civil protection system. The massive presence in the area with the technical teams up to 50 per day, the participation of all the ministries departments in emergency management in order to deal with the subsequent stages of restoration and reconstruction with the utmost awareness of and effectiveness in parallel with the emergency structures on when this would have ended their activities. Next, please. The evaluation of emergency activities is remarkable, both from the point of view of coordination actions and from those operating on the ground. During the emergency, almost nine directives and many provisions at operational level has been issued by the Secretary General. Thousands of tons of ruins have been selected. Almost 6,000 damage assessments were made in the immovable cultural heritage, in monuments, churches, etc., and more than 2,000 participations in the technical support group requested by the local authorities are ensured by the technicians of the ministry. Over 1,200 temporary interventions have been carried out to make historical monuments safe. Over 25,000 movable artifacts were saved in deposits and restored with first aid. Over 10,000 books and over 5 linear kilometers of archival documents were recovered. Over 700 ministries volunteer technicians and thousands of other association volunteers participated. The rescue of a cultural heritage was neither simple nor quick, nor can it be considered concluded. However, despite being full aware of what still needs to be done, we can believe that an immense work has been carried out along all the lines of action of the emergency intervention with excellent results that are appreciated primarily by the local community. Next, please. It's also true that it would have been better if many preventive interventions had been made. Thank you for your attention. Thank you very much, Alessandra. Good morning to everybody and thanks for the invitation. I'm very pleased to attend to this conference with very important topics, particularly the issue of risk and emergency actions, which I mainly dealt with in the last 2 years of my working life in the ministry, is very serious because it has a deep effect on the prevention of cultural heritage. Next, please. Thank you. In theory, the risk analysis should be the basis on which planning the conservation actions. In the practice applied to the cultural heritage is a very complicated process due to the features which the cultural heritage has. We can speak about the typological differences of the monumental structures and of the variability of the dimensions, the management models and the subjects as state, municipality, a private citizen, Catholic Church. We can speak about the number of risks, natural ones and anthropic ones. We can speak about the great gap between artistic and historical knowledge in the one hand and scientific knowledge in the other hand. Particular chemical, physical knowledge necessary to analyze the risk. Next, please. Next, please. Thank you. The transition from risk theory to prevention requires an in-depth knowledge of the specific conditions of a monument that affect its vulnerability, building typologies, constructive features, quality of material, executive expertise, changes introduced by reconstruction and transformations of the architectural and distribution structure, following changes in the use that have altered the structural strength. Above all, the decay of both surfaces and structures due to lack of maintenance. Moreover, the interest of maintenance has always been directed towards the conservation and restoration more of the decorative elements than of the structural components. And this not only for buildings in the poor environmental context, but also for monuments of more historical and artistic value. This in-depth knowledge requires many investments in documentation and analysis. Public investments in this area have always been modest, and consequently, very few economic resources have been invested in prevention, so generating a large gap between the extent of the risk and appropriate operations that could have mitigated seriousness through positive actions aimed at improving the structure strength. The results deriving from this analysis process should constitute the most effective decision support for correct planning in a context of allocation of scarce resources, as by definition public resources are. But unfortunately, the correct approach was not chosen, instead of programmatic decision that mostly responded to different logics. So we must take note that prevention is difficult. The culture of prevention is lacking. Next, thank you. This, the next slide. It is clear to everyone that in Italy, the greatest natural risk is the seismic one. All of us know the enormous damage in terms of human lives and loss of assets, including cultural heritage, caused in Italy by earthquakes that have happened several times over the centuries, often in the same areas. Yet there are many rules introduced for the prevention of seismic risk, but which have defined the two concepts, structural adaptation and structural improvement. An almost 50-year-long debate concluded that, as regarding movable cultural heritage, the measures to be taken are those aimed at improvement and not at adaptation. The Ministry has adopted some sample provisions. I gladly remember my disposition of April 30, 2015, issued as General Secretariat, which also provided for a very simple procedure for acquiring knowledge elements and carrying out transformation actions with the purpose of prevention with reference to the extraordinary maintenance. Particular, without intervening on a global level and with economically modest interventions, critical issues can be eliminated, mostly local, able to of originating even significant collapse mechanism. Therefore, the planned elimination of modest critical issues could constitute a sustainable intervention strategy to reduction of widespread risk. Yet the vast majority of citizens don't have an adequate perception of it, so much so that, unlike what happened for energy saving policies with Ecobonus, incentives for seismic strengthening interventions through tax benefits had very little success as Sisma Bonus. For the same reason, public programs based on risk assessment and therefore prevention are practically absent. In fact, they would require a long-term vision to evaluate the effectiveness of the investment, while in general, the programs being linked to political and government cycles have a much less broad horizon. The failure of preventive interventions involves increasing investment of resources in emergency and then for recovery of cultural heritage after disastrous events such as earthquakes. This is exactly what happened after the earthquake in central Italy in 2016, which has caused immense damage to the cultural heritage of our regions, Lazio, Marche, Abruzzo and Umbria, and involved the 10 provinces, 138 municipalities, about 8,000 square kilometers of territory. Next, please. Thank you. The geographical singularity of the seismic events has been widely analyzed and described in numerous research studies and publications. The macroseismic scenario showed the phenomena that never happened before. The succession of three different events within a short time with maximum magnitude 6.5. The line of epicenters has moved to the northeast, affecting only partially coinciding and ever wider territories. The most violent event was that of October 30, which caused the geological fractures visible on the ground surface on the Mount Vettore. The damage also to the physical structures was immense, due to the progressive weakening of the resistance capacities of the same, not only monumental structures, but also widespread historical building in the small villages scattered in the Apennine Mountains. The effect has been different. Territorial structures and the landscape have been completely and deeply transformed. Some small cities have been razed to the ground as Amatrice, Accumuli, Arquata, and many other small villages which seemed bombed. Cities like Camerino apparently seem almost intact. Actually, they are completely unusable. They are dead cities. Next, please. In the earthquake series of unfavorable circumstances happened, the repetition of events that with big violence have weakened more and more structures that since the first shock had lost much of the initial strength capacity. The largely prevalent functional typology of heritage that were churches has a greater vulnerability than the others. The construction typology of historic building characterized by poor materials and techniques further vulnerable due to the numerous transformation it has undergone over the centuries. As regard to the exposure, the earthquake struck heritage of extraordinary interest from the symbolic churches of the Christian Middle Ages, such as San Benedetto and Orcia, to the hundreds of remote and tiny villages far from the main roads, but all with at least one church, a palace, a convent, a tower, an artifact of artist interest to which the identity of those populations is anchored. Next, please. As you can see, these numbers present in the ministry's databases are very remarkable. Almost 7,000 historical buildings and over 70,000 movable artifacts has been hit. Next, please. All the activities started since the first minutes of the emergency are based on the awareness of operating with an integrated approach to the specific problems of cultural heritage, however, always closely linked with all the others, one, public safety, viability, anthropic safety. The ministry has played a fundamental role into the complex machine coordinated by the civil protection, showing organizational efficiency and effective implementation, despite a continuous and painful stop and go due to the recurrence of the seismic shocks, which led to the painful loss of some monuments. These results have been possible by a well-defined organizational model with specific protocols developed in peacetime by the ministry with the directive of April 23, 2015. This model provides for a national coordinating structure headed by the Secretary General, National Crisis Unit, and many regional crisis units headed by the regional secretaries of cultural heritage. Next, please. This is the chart, the flow chart, the national unit crisis and the regional crisis unit. Next, please. The regional crisis units are organized into three operating units. Units for detecting damage to cultural heritage with the task of managing the damage detection teams, checking and archiving the survey files. Technical coordination unit for the security interventions. Temporary storage unit and emergency service laboratory on movable cultural heritage. The effectiveness of the ministry's action was strengthened with the appointment of the Secretary General as the implementing body to ensure the organization, mobilization, and deployment of the ministry's operating activities aimed at identifying, planning, and coordinating the execution of interventions for the safety of movable and immovable cultural heritage. In this way, the integration of the ministry component into the emergency structure was made stronger, and particularly made collaboration with the fire brigade easier and more efficient. Next, please. The emergency activities carried out by the ministry concerned diversified and very complex, both by the round's nature and due to the surrounding details determined by the earthquake. In Dels Ued, the detection of the damage, first at the expedition level, then at an in-depth level with a detailed survey aimed at identifying the interventions for the safety. The participation in the technical support groups, the aim was to speed up the assessment and decision-making moments by the measures of the community in the presence of risks for public safety or interruptions to the road systems. To make the monument safe with urgent interventions, which due to the complexity of the damage and of the buildings often required complex structural calculations. To make the movable artifacts safe with the recovery in temporary deposits. The temporary protection of the collapsed sites to prevent winter weather from causing ever greater decay to the buried works. The rubble management. In the second phase, the recovery of movable artifacts as places become accessible and safe for operators. Okay, next, please. In the organization of the emergency, the Comando Carabinieri Tutela Patrimonio Culturale, CCTPC, has played an important role by the central office and the 8 operating units. Next, please. Next, please. The operational deployment described above all has allowed to guarantee the necessary coordination with the structure external to the administration in charge of emergency management, as has actually happened on time with the inclusion in the civil protection system. The massive presence in the area with the technical teams up to 50 per day, the participation of all the ministries departments in emergency management in order to deal with the subsequent stages of restoration and reconstruction with the utmost awareness of and effectiveness in parallel with emergency structures on when this would have ended their activities. Next, please. The evaluation of emergency activities is remarkable, both from the point of view of coordination actions and from those operating on the ground. During the emergency, almost nine directives and many provisions at operational level has been issued by the Secretary General. Thousands of tons of ruins have been selected. Almost 6,000 damage assessments were made in the immovable cultural heritage, in monuments, churches, etc. And more than 2,000 participations in the technical support group requested by the local authorities are ensured by the technicians of the ministry. Over 1,200 temporary interventions have been carried out to make historical monuments safe. Over 25,000 movable artifacts were saved in deposits and restored with first aid over 10,000 books and over 5 linear kilometers of archival documents were recovered. Over 700 ministries volunteer technicians and thousands of other association volunteers participated. The rescue of a cultural heritage was neither simple nor quick, nor can it be considered concluded. However, despite being fully aware of what still needs to be done, we can believe that an immense work has been carried out along all the lines of action of the emergency intervention, with excellent results that are appreciated primarily by the local community. Next, please. It's also true that it would have been better if many preventive interventions had been made. Thank you for your attention.